Ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure and honor to call on stage an Indian celebrity, a chef, an entrepreneur, and a television personality. He stars in the TV show Khana Khazana, which is the longest running show of its kind in Asia. It has been broadcast in 120 countries in 2010. And I want you to make a guess, how many views could he have had? How many views? Anybody? 5 million. 10 million. 500 million views is what that show had. Can we give him a big round of applause, please? He has also launched his food channel in January 2011 and Discovery Communications, through its Indian organization, has acquired a majority stake in Mr. Kapoor's channel. Ladies and gentlemen, he is a Padma Shri, and Padma Shri is the fourth highest honor in our country. He has won IT awards for Popular Chef for his Zaike Hind. He's won it for the Best Cookery Show for 3 years on Khana Khazana. He's won Star Parivar Awards for being the favorite judge at MasterChef India. Ladies and gentlemen, big round of applause. Let's have on stage Mr. Sanjeev Kapoor.
I want to take you through my journey a little bit so that you know that how each one of us can really and literally see the stars. And it's something which what most people may dream of, but how dreams can turn into reality, and it's us who do it. I think that's what we all want, right? So, of course, I started studying, I did everything, but I did not have a clue that who a chef was. Mujhe ye nahi pata tha ki chef kya hota hai. I had no clue. Hamare ghar mein kisi ko nahi pata tha chef kaun hota hai. This is important to know, because many people think that when you do something well, maybe it is your passion. It is something that you have always wanted to do, and if you have your heart into it, you will really make it big. So I must clarify this. I didn't know, as a child, I didn't know who a chef was. My hobby was not cooking when I was a child. I did not know what cooking is all about. My brother's hobby was cooking, but he is a strategy consultant today. He did his chartered accountancy, so that's a different thing. But to me, the only thing that I wanted to do was to do something that was different, something that nobody in our family, neighborhood, friends had ever done. That was my motivation when it came to a career choice. And that's when I decided to go towards hotel. And in hotels, I decided to become a chef. And I did that. I became a chef. And my first posting was in a small hotel, 84-room hotel, in Varanasi, in Banaras. And I'm little over 20 years old. I'm in that hotel. And those were the days when chefs were not really respected. Chefs were not people who were cool, who were called on stages like this to speak. Chefs were always in the kitchen. Chefs were somebody who, people who just cooked for a living. That's what they did. I went to that hotel, and I realized that I had to do something differently. I had to create my mark in a place that I was there. I was a chef understudy there, and I started working. And I was working, and they were, so I was the boss, yet at the same time, I was learning from senior people who were there. And those senior people were cooks. They would not teach you anything. Because cooking was all about keeping secrets. Cooking was all about keeping everything to their chest that, ye nahi batayenge, ye batayenge, toh humare paas kya rahega? So I was going through that turmoil that I had to manage a team. I had to learn from them. I had to learn from a bunch of people who were not teaching. I had to control them. And I was young and raring to go. I was trying to do something which was very different. And nothing was really going my way. One day I decided, I said, okay, maybe this is the part that I don't get really well, that the kitchen environment is very difficult to change. Maybe I will go out and see what I can do there. So we used to have a large group of tourists who would come into the hotel and they would stay with us. And typically, when a group would check in, they will all gather in the lobby, there would be, group leader would be there. So I decided that I will go and speak to the tour leader and ask that what do they want to eat? Because we were just making what was being cooked for years. So we had few menus, Monday would be this, Tuesday would be this, no matter what the group was, no matter, yes, there were nationalities, for Russians we will cook this, for Germans we will cook this, if someone came from Buddhist sector, this would be the menu. And that's it, we were just replicating, we were not really doing much, and I was not happy with that. So I actually went to the lobby, there was a check-in, and I went to meet the tour leader, and I went to ask him that, what would they like to eat? And they said, oh, sorry, what do you mean? I said, no, you have your group of 33 people. And so if there are any special that you want, any taste preference. That tour leader said that, I've been coming to this hotel for 11 years. Nobody has ever asked this question. He says, it's a welcome change. So I really like that you want to know. He said, let me check and come back to you because I'm also not prepared for this question. So let me come back to you. I said, fair enough. And he went to the group to ask, and I was waiting. And I see general manager of our hotel walking into the lobby, and he looks at me, and he sees me standing in my uniform with cap, everything, and he calls me chef. And I go to him. I said, yes, sir. He said, what are you doing here? I said, no, sir, I came to meet the tour leader. And that GM said, no, but you're not allowed to be in the lobby. I said, sorry? He said, no, you should be in the kitchen. Now, this is important. Why I am saying this is, this happened with me. I'm not giving story of someone else. I was actually called by a GM standing in the lobby of a hotel that, chef, you're not allowed to be in the lobby. Chefs were not people who were respected. Chefs were not people who were revered. Chefs were, in India I'm taking, not globally. Chefs were not people who could be put on pedestal. Chefs were meant to do a job. It was not front of the house. So hotels have two distinct areas. Front of the house, back of the house. And kitchen was definitely back of the house. There are many back of the house services that you have. And kitchen was back of the house. I was very disturbed. I was very hurt. And I thought that this is something that I have to change. So I made two promises to myself that day. And one promise was that I have to change this paradigm, that when people come to kitchen to learn, new people, new chefs, when they come to learn the kitchen, their learning should be easy. And I thought, what is the part that I can play? I made a promise to myself that whatever I learn, I would teach without restriction and as early as possible. Whatever learning I have, I would pass it on as quickly as possible. It was in my control, right? This was something that I could do. No chef was doing that. People were not They wanted to keep secrets to themselves. And I said, this is the change that I would make. And second promise that I made to myself is that I will change this thinking that chefs are not allowed to be in the lobby. And I can tell you that it took me few years, but today, I must also tell you, at times, mujhe aisa lagta hai, itne chefs, jab main baaki jagah dekhta hu, main kaha, kitchen mein bhi jaya karo kabhi tum log ab. But it is true, it's definitely changed, things have changed, and how is that happened? And why is it relevant in a platform like this for NAR? Because I think there's a similarity that we have, what we had and what you have. I think there is always something which is missing and which if one focuses on, it can change the paradigm. It is something which is there, we can see it, but we just don't act on it. So there was a few things I did and I'll share quickly as to what I did with those things. So I started working and I naturally had to make sure that while I had this dream of teaching, I had dream of making sure that chefs are known, they are respected. I also wanted to reach up the ladder very quickly. And that was a pretty simple thing. It was at that time to reach top of the ladder in kitchen. It used to take about for a very, very good chef to be at the top of the ladder in 20 years. Again, I made a promise to myself that I'll do it in 10 years. And the only way to do it is everyone works 8 hours, you work 16. 20 years comes down by half, 10 years, that's easy, right? So that's exactly what I planned. I did that. I was lucky, rules of the game change. I reached top of my ladder at when I was 28. I became the executive chef for a large hotel in India, got the award for the best executive chef at 28 in Mumbai. And actually that was where the worry started. That's when the problem started. Because at 28, when you have reached your peak, what do you do then? Because ab iske baad mein kya karoge? Matlab aise hi retire ho gaye aap kya? 28 saal mein aapko sab kuch ho gaya, aap best executive chef ho gaye, ab sari zindagi yahi karte rahenge. So there are few things I have done which I'll like to share, which have helped me. And in that, three core things I must share first. One is our field is a field of skill. So we have to, it's like if you are a singer, you have to be very good at your singing. If you are a cricketer, if you are a batsman, you have to be very good at batsman. That's a skill. So cooking is a game of skill. So I had to focus on my skill. So as many skills as I could master, I started to work on that and I spent bulk of my time on that. And I realized that most people who were focusing on skill were actually, they were not focusing on the knowledge around that skill. It's one good thing to know and be good in skill. You can be a very good painter and you paint a very good painting. But if you know the science of painting, science of colors, then you can do much more. So the knowledge of cooking, I started to combine with the skill of cooking. And these two, I started to become very, very good with this and everyone started to recognize me. And the third part was, I realized importance of something which it came naturally to me. All the value system that I was brought in, all the boring things that parents taught, what the school taught, whatever the... So three pillars, I would say, skill, knowledge, and value system, I started to focus on. And once I did that, I realized that now it was easy to break everything. And once I started to see early success, I think it's important to understand, to do well, to start to get respect, to start to get noticed. You have to do things that are outstanding. You cannot be an average person and think that people will start to notice you. Now, not everyone can be outstanding, right? It's not easy. It's unfair to say that everyone can be outstanding. It's it's an ask which cannot be kept, right? So, but I think there is this, there's some method in that madness. And my early discovery of that was that if you have the guts to stand out, अगर आप कुछ ऐसा कर सकते हो जो बाकी लोगों से नहीं किया जाता, जो बाकी लोग नहीं कर सकते, anything that people say कि पागल है ये क्या कर रहा है, anything which you have the actual courage to stand out, if most people are waiting that I want to blend in, I just don't want to stand out, but I have seen that if you have the courage to stand out, the chances of becoming outstanding are much, much higher. And that's what I started to do. I started to stand out. And as soon as I started to stand out, my chances of success were higher. And at times people may say that you may have taken a path which is less traveled. I said, whatever, you may say whatever you want to say, but I have method in my madness. So I discovered that if I start to stand out, it easily becomes approachable for the path that I want to take. Then I realized that by standing out, what it does, it automatically, that inertia is broken. You have got that courage. And now, once that happens, when you are one amongst many who is standing out, you realize that one who stands out starts to lead also automatically, just by the choice that person has made. The choice of standing out gives you the courage, and just because you have stood out, most people who love to be followed, they suddenly become your followers. And you become the leader, and then you get used to it. You had the courage to stand out, that got you noticed, that gave other people the belief that, oh, this person is standing out, is must be outstanding, is a leader, and you certainly have followers. And once you have that chain, it's fairly simple. And I think in each area, if we can follow that, I'm sure that all of us here believe that there are things in our profession that we can do which make us stand out. So if everyone is saying yes, I say no. If everyone is going this way, I go this way. If everyone is saying that, oh, it is like this, I say, no, it is like this. Just to, what it does, it catches attention. It catches attention. Once you have caught, because we are in a country of 1.3 billion people. It is important to catch attention. It is important to catch that kind of, not just attention, that kind of following, if you have to bring to the table. The only way you can do it is when people start to see that, acha kuch to hoga ye kya keh rahe hai, matlab aise kyun keh rahe hai. If I start to say ki piche barish kitni zabardast aa rahi hai, oh my god, I didn't even think that wahan piche sara khula hua hai, right? It's raining so heavily, right? Some people will start to turn ki piche kitni barish aa rahi hai, right? Over a period of time, do baar char baar bolenge, fir sare log piche dekhna shuru kar denge. थोड़ी देर में बारिश भी होनी शुरू हो जाती है, ऐसा होता है, राइट? दैट इज द पावर ऑफ बिलीफ. दैट इज द पावर ऑफ बिलीफ, कि पता चला कि बारिश भी वहां पे होनी शुरू हो गई. नो, बट द पॉइंट आई एम नॉट सेइंग इज नॉट टू जस्ट सेंसलेसली स्टैंड आउट, बट इन योर एरिया ऑफ स्पेशलाइजेशन, इफ यू स्टार्ट टू फोकस ऑन एरियाज दैट यू वॉन्ट टू लुक एट एंड फोकस ऑन दिस एरियाज, इट्स फेयरली सिंपल. एंड देन देर इज, इफ यू गेट अर्ली सक्सेस, दैट्स क्रिटिकल. Success is critical. Small success is good enough. Success kya karti hai? We like to play games that we play well. Jo cheeze hame achhi karni aati hai hum baar baar karte hain. Jo cheeze hum nahi kar sakte hain wo nahi karte hain. Hum usse bhagte rehte hain, hum chupte rehte hain. We never do things that we are not good at, right? So let's start focusing on quick wins, early successes. And once you do that, apna confidence apne aap badh jata hai. So when I started टीवी, मैंने शो शुरू किया, एंड आई रियलाइज दैट आई वॉज जस्ट गोइंग टू बी वन शेफ आउट ऑफ 26 शेफ्स, बिकॉज इट वॉज अ सीरीज ऑफ 26 पार्ट्स. वन शेफ एवरी वीक वुड कम एंड कुक, सो आई वॉज वन ऑफ दोज 26 शेफ्स. एंड आई रियलाइज दैट I had to do something different. And what is the different thing I could do? So I started interacting with the producer and director more than any other chef. अच्छा ये क्या होता है कैसे होता है क्या है किसके लिए शो कौन देखेगा कौन सा टीवी चैनल देयर वाज नो जी टीवी वाज टू स्टार्ट एट दैट टाइम आई स्टार्टेड टू लर्न आई स्टार्टेड टू अंडरस्टैंड वंस आई डिड दैट आई रियलाइज दैट आई न्यू मच मोर देन एनी अदर शेफ हु वाज गोइंग टू बी ऑन द सेम शो वंस आई अंडरस्टूड आई रियलाइज दैट ये जो प्रोग्राम है इट इज नॉट फॉर माय व्यूअरशिप मुझे नहीं देखना ना बाकी जो शेफ्स हैं उनके लिए नहीं है इट इज नॉट मेंट फॉर देम इट इज मेंट फॉर पीपल हु वांट टू लर्न हाउ टू कुक इट इज नॉट मेंट फॉर शेफ्स व्हाइल अदर शेफ्स रिमेंबर एट दैट टाइम आई वाज द बेस्ट एग्जीक्यूटिव शेफ ऑफ द कंट्री एंड ऑल द अदर शेफ्स वर आल्सो वेरी वेरी गुड हु केम ऑन द शो नॉट मेनी पीपल नो दिस दो दे थॉट कि आई स्टार्टेड द शो एंड आई बीन डूइंग इट सो व्हेन आई डिड that I understood all other chefs were showing off. They were showing things that they were good at, while I showed things that when people watched it, they would become good at. That was just a simple thing that I did. And all the senior chefs, when I started with the show, I actually got a call from a very senior chef who was the number one very senior chef. He called me one day. I was in the hotel. I distinctly remember. He said, "Sanjeev, tera show dekha yaar, kya kar raha hai? You are the award-winning chef. Matlab chhas bata raha tha tu TV mein." I said, "Yes, sir." He says, "Aise kyun chef logon ka naam kyun kharab kar raha hai?" I said, "Why?" He said, "No, it's such a simple thing." And I said, "No, sir, mujhe to jo aata hai, main wohi bataunga na." He said, "Nahi, don't do that. Why are you spoiling chef's name?" I tried to explain what I just said, that it's not about me. And then I told him, I said, "I showed chhas, but in north of India, it is very different. It's matha, it's lassi, it's nirmor. There are different variants of one thing. And just within India, people may not know one from the other. So we need to explain. We have to make sure that people know." He did not agree. Most chefs did not agree with me. Most, and I have had this, I would say, a streak of madness in me. When more people disagree with me, I would say, "Oh, phir to theek hi hoga. Sab log disagree kar rahe hain, to mujhe karna chahiye." So I must tell you. Now, date for this was fixed some time back, a few months back. And at that time, we didn't know our Honorable PM would have a trip to UAE. If you remember, last two visits, I was with him because I'm always the guest of the rulers of UAE to be there. All our team, as soon as it came, "Sir, ab kya karenge?" Maine kaha, "Kuch nahi, jo commitment hai, wohi karenge. Commitment hai, yahan pe hai, aur aapke paas mein." Because you cannot change commitment. That's something. So dates are sacrosanct to me. Commitments, contracts, agreements, they are sacrosanct to me. I tell my daughters, maine kaha, "Bete, kabhi na zindagi mein decide kar lo ki shaadi karni hai. To mujhe kam se kam 3 to 6 months ka time de dena. Aisa nahi ho, mere paas date nahi ho, aur aapne decide kar li to phir main nahi aa paaunga." So for me, that's, I'm sure that in all your profession, that's exactly what you do. In terms of one other thing that I did differently from all the other chefs, and I think that everyone can embrace, is use of technology. Use of technology is something which I was very particular with. And I'll quickly give you a few examples of what I did. In 1990, I think it was maybe 96. Yeah, many people didn't even have computers at that time. I started my own website, sanjeevkapoor.com. People didn't even know what a website was at that time. I did that. Much before I launched my first book, I launched a CD-ROM. When the total population of CD computers with CD-ROM drive was less than 50,000 in this country. I launched that. Okay, forget that. Those are early days. In recent times, YouTube channel, I started almost, I think 12 years ago, a channel on YouTube on cooking. As soon as I started my TV channel, I started working on a channel on YouTube. And everyone said that, oh, why are we doing that? TV people pay, YouTube people don't pay. I said, no, it's OK. I know what we're doing. It's my commitment. I have to teach. So this is what we have to do. Today, we have, so there were some millions and all we're doing. Those are figures from Wikipedia, right? And that also somebody else to update. We cannot do that. We don't believe in that because that's the platform it is meant to be. It's not whatever is there. It's people driven. It's not what we want to drive. But the numbers today are not in millions. They are in billions. Just on YouTube, we get about 30 million every month. You keep on adding, and that's just YouTube. Forget Facebook, forget Instagram, forget all other things. Collective influence. So if we have to change the world, if we have to make sure that we are successful, then we have to make our area of influence much larger than what it was yesterday. That is critical. If we can do that, because agar hum ye sochenge ki hamesha hum to kuwe hain aur ghoda hamare paas hamesha aayega, nahi nahi. Zamana badal gaya. I think we need to make more effort. And I'm sure in your trade, that's exactly what you do, make that effort. But in terms of, I would love to spend more time, but I have to be watchful of the time also. And I want to give some time to some interactive, some questions that I would like to answer. So I would say that if one has to look at from where, with the prism that the world is seeing, the world of realtors today, if that has to, there has to be a titanic shift into that, then how it can happen would be if one, individually, and two, collectively, the way organizations like this do, is by making sure that the influence, the collective influence, is something which is much more. So the tool that I used, one was I started to educate my users. So today, any client that I have, so you would see that I endorse Tata Salt. I endorse Tata Sampan. I endorse Tata Sampan range of products, but it's not only the face that I use. It's the whole 360 degrees where the product development is also done by me. We develop the product, we develop the process, we develop all of that, and it's not just with Tata, with Dawat Rice I would do. So what we do is that we use our same principle of teaching, that agar hum kisi ko sikhayenge, to kaam apne aap aa jayega. Once you take the position of a teacher, ek cheez yaad rakhiye, agar jis din aap teacher ban jate hain, aap guru ban jate hain, guru ki hamesha, guru is always revered, is always respected. It is a great position to be. So whatever knowledge that you have, your user, your buyer, whoever you are dealing with, if you can leave them with any information, any knowledge from your area of specialization, they will appreciate. Most of the time, they say, "Humko hum sab bata denge, to bahut gadbad ho jayegi. Phir to hamare koi agli baar puchenge, hame sikhayenge. Humne agar inko bata diya ki ye samjha do, inko ye samjha do, ye bata do ki aise nahi karna chahiye, aise karna chahiye. Phir to hamare ko hamara hamari zarurat kya rahegi logon ko, right? But I can tell you that personal example. I have felt that more I have shared, more I have gained. More I have given, more I have got. But that giving has to be unconditional. It should not come from a threat perception. It should not come from ki, are kya hoga? Nahi, bina dare, unconditionally. It's like love. When you give unconditional love, you get unconditional love. And that's what I believe, that if today collectively you decide that this profession will start giving unconditionally, I can tell you the consumers, the users of your services, the way it will come back to you in a positive way, you have no clue. People may say that aaj ki date mein technology itni ho gayi, it's a disruption bahut sari cheezon mein, but there's always relationship is beyond everything. We have, while technology can enable things, technology can make things easy, but technology can still not create relationships. Technology does not know emotion. The way I speak, the way I look at a person in the eye, technology still cannot deliver that. So let's use technology to our advantage. Let's not get scared of technology, because I know that in today's day and age where services are there, we are always scared of technology and we don't embrace. So I would say embrace it open-heartedly, create a larger area of influence, work on skill and knowledge, and don't give up any of the value system that you have been brought up. And with the courage to stand out, there is no way on earth that in this room full, maybe in world of realtors, maybe forget a Padma Shri, you would have a Bharat Ratna coming out of this room. And that's my wish, that's my prayer, that's my hope.
Sanjeev ji, pleasure meeting you once again. My quick question, now I'm runner also. Just for your kind information, I used to run with holding hands, but now I run without holding hands, even though I cannot see. And this year I'm planning to run 21 kilometers. Now, coming back to my questions, Sanjeev ji, biryani ko mana karna bada mushkil hota hai. Roll ko mana karna bada mushkil hota hai. Kuch aisa tips bataye ki hum apne healthy foods ko kaise adopt kare apne life mein.
Wah, kya baat. Asif sahab, bahut badhiya. तो पहली बात तो ये कि खाने को मना करना या नहीं करना ये इंडिविजुअल चॉइस होती है. एंड बहुत अच्छी बात है कि भागते हैं आप. एंड व्हाट एन इंस्पिरेशनल स्टोरी दैट यू हैव आज़िज़ साहब. इट्स आई थिंक वी ऑल वुड लर्न फ्रॉम दैट. एंड आई मस्ट ऑल्सो टेल यू कि मैंने कुछ साल पहले ये डिसाइड किया, मैं 100 मीटर भी नहीं भाग सकता था. मैं 100 मीटर भी नहीं भाग सकता. आई स्टार्टेड टू वर्क विद ऑटिस्टिक किड्स मेनी इयर्स अगो. उन्होंने कहा कि आपको कुछ पैसे रेज करने हैं और उसके लिए आपको मैराथन में भागना पड़ेगा. और मैंने सिर्फ उनको हेल्प करने के लिए थोड़ा ट्रेनिंग करना शुरू किया. 100 मीटर के बाद में तो मेरी हालत ऐसी हो जाती हाफ हाफ के. टुडे आई कैन रन फॉर आवर्स. इट्स जस्ट द परसिस्टेंस, इट्स जस्ट द माइंड दैट इफ द माइंड डिसाइड्स एवरीथिंग कैन फॉलो. कमिंग टू बिरयानी, आई थिंक हर चीज़ में अगर हम ये डिसाइड कर लें कि अति जो है किसी भी चीज़ की ख़राब है, अति चाहे वो बिरयानी की हो, अति चाहे वो प्यार की हो, अति चाहे ऑक्सीजन की हो, अति या किसी भी चीज़ की हो, आई थिंक मॉडरेशन इज द की. खाने में कोई ख़राबी नहीं होती. कभी बिरयानी को टाइफॉइड नहीं हुआ, कभी बिरयानी को हार्ट अटैक नहीं हुआ, कभी बिरयानी को कुछ ऐसा नहीं हुआ. प्रॉब्लम हम में होती है, दोष हम बिरयानी को देते हैं. My younger daughter, she's an athlete, she's a national level athlete, she runs like a dream, and she eats everything because she knows ki subah 5 baje utke wo 2.5 ghante aise bhagti hai, kuch bhi kha sakti hai. Hum log baki sari cheeze karne se thoda sa katrate hain aur phir khane ko dosh dete hain. Khane mein I think moderately agar hum kha le, pehla signal jab kahin kuch kharab aaye hamare paas mein. So I came back last night from Singapore. I reached, मेरी फ्लाइट कुछ लेट हो गई. मैं 1:40 पे मुंबई पहुंचा. घर पहुंचते पहुंचते 2 हो गए. सुबह उठा तो क्योंकि सिंगापुर में 1.5 दिन था, कुछ उल्टा सीधा ऐसा खा लिया तो पेट मुझे लगा ये गड़बड़ है कुछ नहीं. नाउ आई वॉज कमिंग टू हैदराबाद. मेरे दिमाग में हैदराबाद जाऊंगा, बिरयानी खाऊंगा, सब बढ़िया से सब कुछ खाऊंगा. बड़ा दिल था, ये सब कुछ था. बट आई एग्जैक्टली मेरे दिमाग में जब ये मैसेज आया कि पेट में गड़बड़ है, आई अराइव्ड हेयर इन दी होटल. फ्लाइट 8 बजे पहुंच गई थी, 9 बजे इस होटल में पहुंच गया था मैं. 9 बजे से अब तक एक सेब मैंने खाया है इन सिटी ऑफ हैदराबाद बीइंग अ शेफ, क्योंकि मेरे पास मैसेज आ गया था कि कंट्रोल आप सवारी अपने सामान की खुद जिम्मेवारी है, भारतीय रेल पहले लिख के रखता था, आप अपने शरीर के खुद जिम्मेवार हैं। तो ये मेरा मानना है। बट यू आर एन इंस्पिरेशन साहब, यू आर इंस्पिरेशन टू ऑल ऑफ अस। यस
सर, योर लाइंस आर वेरी इंस्पायरिंग। आई जस्ट वांटेड टू नो क्या आपने लाइफ में ऐसा कोई चैलेंज फेस किया है जिसमें जिस आपको समझ नहीं आ रहा था आपको क्या करना चाहिए और आप उस पर ओवरकम कैसे किया?
ओके, देखिए चैलेंज हर रोज आते हैं। चैलेंज को मतलब अगर इफ वी ब्रेक दैट इनटू स्मॉलर पीसेस, हर रोज आते हैं। और चैलेंजेस के लिए अच्छा ये मैंने एक ये मेरा मानना है, मे बी इट इज़ नॉट समथिंग विच मेनी पीपल अग्री विद मी, आई हैव नेवर सेलिब्रेटेड चैलेंजेस, आई हैव ऑलवेज वर्कड, एंड दिस इज समथिंग आई मस्ट शेयर विद यू कि मैंने आज तक कभी नहीं बताया कि मेरे साथ में कितनी दिक्कतें ऐसे हुई, ऐसे मैं बड़ा उसको टोन डाउन करके रखता हूँ। एंड दैट्स अ बिलीव दैट आई हैव कि जितना हम अच्छा बताएंगे, जितना हम अच्छा शेयर करेंगे, उतनी अच्छी चीज़ें होंगी, उतना लोगों को आसान लगेगा। नाउ एक मेरा बहुत शेफ में हम लोग साथ में पढ़े, कल फ़ोन पर मेरी बात हो रही थी उसके साथ में, सिंगापुर में रहता है वो, तो उसने बताया कि हम मिलने वाले थे, मिल नहीं पाया वो। तो मैंने कहा क्या हो गया मिलिंद, यू हैव नॉट, ही सेज कि नहीं रितिका उसकी वाइफ है, उसकी तबीयत थोड़ी ठीक नहीं है, तो मैं जा रहा हूँ घर। मैंने कहा अच्छा कोई बात नहीं, अगली बार जब आऊँगा तो मिल लेंगे। तो इसे अच्छा मैंने तो ये बताया कि क्या आप उसके साथ में, मैंने कहा नहीं, कहते पिछले 2 साल से शी इज़ सफरिंग फ्रॉम 4th stage cancer एंड शी सेज कि कोई हालत इतनी ख़राब थी, कहते बट वी उसके माइंड की वजह से, और हमने ये कि हम बहुत ज़्यादा इसको ये नहीं करेंगे कि ये हो गया हमारे साथ में, kept on working towards it, and today she is almost out of it, and she said the only reason it has been possible is because of her mind and her commitment, our decision ki hum isko bahut zyada ye isme nahi karenge, are hamare sath mein ye ho gaya hamare sath mein. To maine aaj tak kabhi aise, main bahut baar mein dekh sunta hu ki jab main Mumbai pahuncha to railway station pe mere paas khane ke liye nahi tha 15 din tak. I think all of us have our challenges, but let's embrace them. Let's make sure that challenges सबके पास में होते हैं, और जितने challenges हैं they are all opportunities. हर रोज challenge आएंगे, अगर गिनना शुरू हो जाएंगे तो समय क्यों व्यर्थ करें? Let's look at what is good. Let's celebrate the goodness in life that is there, and that goodness will give us more energy than all the negativity that all the challenges given is my belief, and that's how I live my life.
Hello.
Yes.
Sir.
Sanjeev, good evening.
Yes,
good afternoon, rather. Yes. It's been a brilliant encapsulation of your life journey. And I have found most of the chefs to be master storytellers and extremely charming. Probably it goes with the job of addressing the fairer sex mode. Having said that, with the perspective of healthy living, which I'm sure is the way forward, what is your take and contribution towards bringing the millets, the organic food, and the food of the soil, so to say, back into the mainstream? How do you intend to propagate that? How do you intend to integrate that and make it glamorous, so to say, to be accepted in a normal household?
Sure. So 3 words in that: eat fresh, local, seasonal. Just fresh, local, and seasonal. Jo aapke paas mein hai, wo khaein. Fresh khaein, jo season mein hai, wo khaein. And you'll be healthy. That's the key. और मतलब मैं तो एक और कहना शुरू हो रही है कि पिछले 50 साल में जो हमने जानवरों को खिलाना शुरू कर दिया ना, वो भी खाना शुरू कर दें, बिकॉज हमें ऐसा लगना शुरू हो गया था कि ये हम नहीं खा सकते, जानवरों को खिला रहे हैं। आई थिंक ऑल दी हेल्दी थिंग वी स्टार्टेड उसका चारा बनाना शुरू कर दिया था। सो आई वुड से वी आर रिच इन सो मेनी फूड्स, जैसे मिलेट्स की बात कर रहे हैं हम, सुपर फूड्स जो हैं, ऐसा लगता है क्योंकि अंग्रेजी का शब्द है, शायद बाहर के लोग ही सुपर फूड्स खाते हैं, हमारे यहाँ पे नहीं होते। एवरीथिंग दैट वी ईट, इफ वी ईट with a positive mind, can be a super food. एक एक खाने से नहीं होता, किस सोच के साथ खा रहे हैं, और खाना सिर्फ मुँह में नहीं डाल के, इस समय हम क्या देख रहे हैं, किस भाव से देख रहे हैं, किस भाव से खा रहे हैं, that is equally important. So do not think कि कुछ लोग ऐसे कहते हैं अरे वो कुछ भी खाते हैं उसको कुछ नहीं लगता, हम तो हवा भी खाते हैं हमारा 10 किलो वजन बढ़ जाता है, right? तो किस भाव से खा रहे हैं, keep a focus on that. I'm sorry that I have to rush through these things. I hate to do it, but I'm sorry. But
sir, मैं नासिक महाराष्ट्र से हूँ, नितिन।
नॉर्मली मेरा सवाल डॉक्टर से होना चाहिए मगर वहाँ से प्रॉपर जवाब मिलते नहीं हैं, तो नॉर्मली वेजिटेरियन लोगों में B12 की कमी होती है, तो वो कौन से फूड से कौन से रेशो में मिल सकता है?
ये इंडिया के अंदर दो बड़ी प्रॉब्लम्स जो चल रही हैं, B12 एंड D3 की जो इश्यूज हैं, दे आर रियल प्रॉब्लम्स, एंड यू आर राइट कि जो हम मीट्स वगैरह खाते हैं तो उसमें B12 ज़्यादा मिल जाते हैं. बट सो आई थिंक एक तो है कि आप रेगुलरली किस तरह से कर सकते हैं. सेकंड, व्हाट आई हैव सीन व्हाट वर्क्स इज कि मतलब क्योंकि मैं इस फूड में बहुत सारे एक और मैं बताता हूँ, डॉक्टर्स नहीं बताते हैं डॉक्टर्स का इशू क्या है, क्योंकि मैं बहुत डॉक्टर्स को मिलता हूँ, उनके पास जाता हूँ किसी भी बात के लिए तो एक घंटा एक्स्ट्रा बिठा लेते हैं मुझे. एंड आई वुड से कि क्या कहते हैं, हमें जब डॉक्टरी पढ़ाई जाती है न्यूट्रिशन के दो पेज होते थे, तो उसमें खाने में पूछते हमारे से सब हैं लेकिन हमें पढ़ाया तो था नहीं है. तो उनकी प्रॉब्लम ऐसा नहीं है कि वो नहीं बताना चाहते, बट उनकी इशू है, बट नॉट ऑल डॉक्टर्स. सो आई वुड से कि अगर B12 कम हो गया, एक तो पहले टेस्ट ज़रूर करवाएं, तो उसमें आप B12 पहले तो उसका थोड़ा सा 1 से 3 महीने तक सप्लीमेंट ज़रूर ले लें इफ़ इट इज़ लो, बिकॉज खासतौर से आप प्योर वेजिटेरियन हैं और उसके अंदर और बहुत ज़्यादा इश्यूज़ आ गए हैं कि अगर डेरी भी लोगों ने कम करना शुरू कर दिया, वीगन बनने शुरू हो गए, डेरी फ्री खाना शुरू कर दिया, तो और इश्यूज़ आ जाते हैं. बट नट्स, सेसमी, डेरी, दालें, ये जितने हैं उसको थोड़ा सा बढ़ाना पड़ेगा, बट गिव अ बूस्टर ऑफ एटलीस्ट वंस और ट्वाइस, एक मंथ के लिए हर क्वार्टर में आप सप्लीमेंट ले लें. दैट वी हैव सीन बिकॉज आई वर्क विथ फ्यू डॉक्टर्स एंड वी हैव सीन कि सिर्फ उतना हम फूड से स्पेशली जब कम हो जाता है तो नहीं हो पाता है. तो मतलब हम खुद करते हैं, मेरी माय मॉम इज़ अ वेजिटेरियन, आई हैव बीन आई एम कम फ्रॉम अ वेजिटेरियन हाउस, आई ईट एवरीथिंग, बट सो हम वो देते हैं B2B करके एक है, सो दैट्स व्हाट वी टेक. सो आई वुड से, बट अदरवाइज इट इज़ इट्स अ इशू. Having said that, आप जब विटामिन बी आप देखते हैं तो इट इज़ नॉट कि उसके अंदर B6, B12, जितने भी आप देखेंगे, जितनी हेल्दी चीज़ें होती हैं ना, आप ग्रीन वेजिटेबल्स, फ्रूट्स, मोर फाइबर, मोर प्रोटीन, जितना बैलेंस डाइट जो हम पहले अच्छे से खाते थे, अगर वो सारी चीज़ें करनी शुरू कर देना तो वैसे कम नहीं होता है. इट इज़ नॉट, इट जस्ट दैट हम अति करते हैं, पहले अत्याचार करते हैं अपने सिस्टम पे, फिर उसको हमें हिट करता है, फिर हम कहते हैं कि ओहो अब क्या करें, राइट? रेगुलर एक्सरसाइज, रेस्ट एंड स्लीप, रिजुविनेशन ऑफ बॉडी, फास्टिंग. एक जापानीज डॉक्टर हैं, उनको नोबेल प्राइज इस पे मिला था ऑन फास्टिंग. ये आजकल इंटरमिटेंट फास्टिंग बड़ी फैशन में, तो एक ऑटोफेजी करके चीज़ होती है, जब आप फास्ट करते हैं तो आपके बॉडी में दो तरह के सेल्स होते हैं, एक हेल्दी होते हैं और एक वीक होते हैं. जो वीक वाले हैं वो पहले मरते हैं, और इट हेल्प्स दी न्यूअर सेल्स ग्रो फास्टर, दैट्स अ प्रोसेस ऑफ ऑटोफेजी. तो उस पर एक काफ़ी ज़्यादा, और हमारे यहाँ पे फास्टिंग का जो कॉन्सेप्ट है हिंदुस्तान में इतने सालों से पहले से चला आ रहा है. सो जस्ट 30 seconds ऑन दैट, सो इवन दैट मे बी वेरी गुड. यस, लास्ट क्वेश्चन.
Sanjeev sir, if it's one last question.
One last question, please.
We'll allow this young lady to ask, and this gentleman has been waiting, but his
question. I know, no, bade zor se haath kiya tha,
bade. Very short, so we'll ask
okay,
him.
Sorry, yes.
Sorry, ma'am, I think yes, we'll have
go,
to
go,
continue.
Go. Haan ji.
Hi, Mr. Sanjay. I'm Ravina, I'm an individual architect here in Hyderabad. So I'd like to ask you a question, that you're a master chef, so I personally dream to be a master chef in terms of building. And my forte right now is in residential, so I'd like to ask a question to you. What is it exactly that you would want to have in your house, like in a building?
So, Ravina, I must tell you very quickly here. So, I'm an architect. I went to School of Planning and Architecture, SPA, in Delhi. Oh, wow. Okay. But I decided, you're from SPA? So check the records, yeah, 1981, yeah, you were not even born. So till about 5 years ago, all my projects, till about AutoCAD 10, I used to do my own, right? But I did not pursue architecture. I decided on something because at that time, somebody told me a line, and mere paas choice thi architecture ki, mere paas admission tha पर वेट लिस्ट था, उसके बाद में मुझे एसपीए में, जिनमें स्कूल कॉलेज में गई, और होटल मैनेजमेंट में था. तो मैंने किसी से पूछा कि कैसे मैं क्या चूज़ करूँ. कहते हैं आपकी ये नीड है कि यू हैव टू, यू वांट टू डू समथिंग डिफरेंट, तो होटल मैनेजमेंट कर लो. एंड दैट ही वाज अ कोलीग ऑफ माय फादर, ही सेड वन लाइन व्हिच स्टेड विद मी, एंड ही सेड इट इज़ बेटर टू एक्सेल इन अ मीडियोकर फील्ड देन टू बी मीडियोकर इन एन एक्सेलेंट फील्ड. तो उस समय आर्किटेक्चर एक्सेलेंट फील्ड था, पर दिल से तो आर्किटेक्ट हूँ मैं. तो माई फादर न्यू दैट. तो बहुत सालों बाद उन्होंने कहा कि क्या फ़र्क पड़ता है आर्किटेक्चर नहीं किया तो, बिकॉज आई यूज़ टू डू, माई सिस्टर इन लॉ शी इज़ एन आर्किटेक्ट, मैं उसके प्रोजेक्ट वगैरह अभी मैं बहुत काम कुछ पे करता हूँ. तो यू आर आर्किटेक्ट ऑफ फूड, यू आर फूड आर्किटेक्ट. सो इन टर्म्स ऑफ आई एम एक्चुअली डूइंग अप माई हाउस एंड आई वर्क ऑन ऑल ऑफ दिस. सो मुझे आर्किटेक्ट्स बड़े वैसे अच्छे लगते हैं. लोग कहते हैं कि आप ऐसे डेप्थ एंड डिटेल में कैसे जाते हैं, बिकॉज दैट्स वेयर माई हार्ट इज. क्रिएटिव, इट्स अ क्रिएटिव फील्ड. वॉट वुड आई वॉन्ट इन माई हाउस? I would want it to have a soul. I would want peace and prosperity in my house. I would want happiness in my house. How it is delivered is an architect's job. This is my requirement. I don't want to give the size of the room. I don't want to give all the details. You are an expert in that. If I cook for you, I would bring a smile on your face. That's what I would do. So hamare jo interior architect hain, wo mujhe dekh ke kehte sir kuch to bata do. Main kaha nahi, maine bata diya hai ki mujhe kya chahiye. I am very very clear in what I want. I want positive energy. I want happiness. I want peace. And that's what I want. And it's very very clear. He says ki acha sir, aapko vastu ke hisab se aise. Main kaha mujhe ye kuch nahi pata. मैंने अपनी डेफिनेशन दे दी है, मैंने बता दिया मुझे क्या चाहिए. आई कैनॉट बी शार्पर देन दिस. दिस इज एग्जैक्टली व्हाट आई वांट एंड यू डिलीवर द वे यू वांट टू डू दैट.
आई विल टेक द लिबर्टी ऑफ आस्किंग मी क्वेश्चन. सो आपने हाउस, खाना, प्यार, मोहब्बत, हर चीज पे बात कर दिया, बट डू यू नो हु कैन गिव यू दिस हाउस? ऑल ऑफ दीस 1500 रियल्टर्स हैं.
दैट इज सो ट्रू.
दे आर द वंस हू कैन गिव. सो एट दिस स्टेज आई वॉन्ट टू आस्क यू अ क्वेश्चन सर, ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ एवरीबडी. Mr. Sumant, who's the president of this association today, Shailendra, the chairman, and myself, when we sat down and we were deciding the speakers, and this is a content-driven convention,
sure,
where we decided the subject first and speaker later, trust me, you were our first choice, because 15 saal pehle, 20 saal pehle, chef was a taboo word. No parent would like somebody to become from a cook to a chef. Actually, this industry faces the same thing for a broker, and we are trying to make it most respectable, world-class profession. What is the advice you can give to all of them, sir?
So, only one line, that stop listening to this that you need respect. Start believing you have respect. Start giving that respect. Nobody can give you respect. You have the respect, you will continue to grow. And I can tell you, when I said this, that there would be somebody from this trade who would reach the heights, it will come from that room, because you have the power of belief that you will get that. And it's not the respect you already have. I did not say Padma Shri, what I am. I said Bharat Ratna. I mean it. Please prove me right. Thank you.
Whoa! Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much. Fantastic.